my Wi-Fi antenna test setup. I'll just want to show you a few things. The first thing is, and this is more for the camping community as well, or anybody who wants to have a portable 5G solution that's simple and easy to carry around, this is the tower that I'm using, or the pole that I'm using. So what I have here is, first of all, a speaker tripod, which you can get on RF Shop's website. Everything here you can get on RF Shop's website. Well, almost everything. Let me walk you through this. So the first thing is, there is the BAT120. So that's the battery that's available through through RF Shop, but from Teltonika, that basically acts as a buffer. So it becomes like a night hawk, but supercharged, I would say, because the battery is significantly bigger and more reliable than what you would get in your typical small consumer device. Now you power it up and then you can unplug the power and it just keeps the system running. So it could be acting as a UPS, or you can, in my case, this is the whole setup. So there's no connection to my house, but this is all up and running at this very moment. That connects to my RETX50, so my 5G router. It is Teltonika to Teltonika. They actually do have communication between each other if you wanted to do that. I just use it as a plug-in device. And then my Teltonika is connected with all the antenna ports, 4G, 5G ports, which are four of those. See, I got confused with four and five when I started to say that. Four antenna ports connected to my WiMO 417 from pointing antennas. It also has GPS out. This has GPS, so I connect that in, and it also has Wi-Fi, which for now, with this purpose of this specific setup, is very important. Gets my Wi-Fi to this point. I do prefer this Wi-Fi antenna over the antennas that come with the actual RETX50, because it kind of keeps everything neat and compact. Also, when I go to the beach or anywhere to test my own Wi-Fi antenna, this setup, when I carry it around, it's repeatable. I can just put it on the beach or on the grass and just have that going. The stuff itself, I use the DIN rail mount. So I bought a little DIN rail mount, and I just figured out that just using a U-bolt clamp, it just attaches to my pole, and then the DIN rail itself is there for me to use. So it's pretty compact. I mean, I just put it in the back of the van that I have, and I just carry it with me and set it up without any hassle. If you go camping, this would be great. If you well, camping or anywhere you want to go, if this is if you're able to fit this in your boot, because this of course slaps down, so it can be quite a small setup you can carry around. That's really it. Now, that's the first part of this video. The second part of the video is the crux of what I want to test. So what I have is, this is my 4G, 5G solution. I will put this anywhere I want to put it, and I'm just going to put it off camera. I'll just keep it in camera there for now. And then the other setup is my actual setup here, which is what I will have to carry with me as well, so I could evaluate my antennas. This is the dish. I still have a lot of tests to do on the dish itself, but the dish is then, let me just move this closer. Dish is on a little tripod. You can move this around, connected, as I said last week in a video, through a cable to the alpha card that is in my laptop. That's really all I can do, is just do this test and see if there's any difference wherever I go. Now, what I was doing, because I thought I can't do any tests today, interesting enough, I have it running. I'm not connecting it to this device, which I set up as 3D printed antennas, 5.8 and the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi network. I'm too close. It's just pointless, because it's just a direct connection. But my house internet is that way. And I only use my CarScope Aussie 5 gigahertz band from the house. And what I noticed is, as I track this through, so the screen is still recording, as you could see here, the timestamp now is, it's just dropping down. That's the connection to my house. But what I realized when I set the test up, as this is looking for a signal strength, when I moved it, I could see a difference. Now, the problem that I had last week in my video, is just this collarbone bond, or basically metal shields all around. So when I moved my antenna, when I was on the porch, I get reflections from everywhere. So the test is not great. That's why I want to go to the beach or an open field to actually test the antenna in an open field, as we would do in the antenna world as well. But now, I just turned the antenna away from where I actually want to use it. And the signal strength is reasonably low. I just want to read this out loud. It says minus 56 dBm. It's not too bad, actually, but given what I'm trying to do, that's a number. If I turn this around towards the house in towards where my 5.8 gigahertz access point is, I actually noticed it is doing much more than I was anticipating, which is good. It's good. I mean, that's what you want to see, but I think it's going to be so much easier to get a repeatable, illustratable test when I don't have all these other access points around that can mess up my measurements. And I also don't have any major reflections coming from surfaces other than maybe the ocean itself or so forth. I had better results when I was positioned there, so I did this just when I moved the table to the screen. I did muck up my test result a little bit, so I'm just going to move this back to where I was, and I point it towards the house. Do nothing else than that. I'll just let this wait, so let the time run so that it stabilizes a bit. You can see the signal actually is quite good. It's rising, so the signal strength that I read on my screen now that I look at it is minus 45. So I'm looking at a minus 45 dBm RSSI or signal strength for my 5.8 gigahertz test used connected to my home Wi-Fi internet using the alpha card going through my antenna that I still need to evaluate properly. So that is just an observation. If I turn the antenna around, basically testing it as if it's not working then, so it's pointing in the wrong direction, you should see a difference, because the antenna is meant to have different gain in that direction. It should actually be pretty low. So let's see what we get. So it's dropping down, and it takes quite a while to stabilize. So fast forward on the video itself, we don't want to just wait for me to do what I have to do. Okay, this has definitely stabilized. I took some time there. It is now at minus 64 dBm signal strength. So the antenna turning has made that difference. I will just, as a cross point, turn it back to where I had it before. I turn the antenna. That's all that I'm doing. As you can see, I'm not touching any buttons. I'm not doing anything on the computer. And the difference, the jump that you see there, immediately jumps up to, right now it reads minus 50. Now it will be optimization to find the right direction, because of course it's going into the house, into the property. There's all sorts of reflections, so I don't know exactly where it needs to point for the right point. Which is another thing that would be, see, I just turned it and it's actually going up significantly. That's another thing on the beach. It's me, it's the source, that's it. A lot of talking, sorry about that. I'm really excited to get these antennas tested and play with them outside in the on the beach. That's it. So as you can see, the principle is working really, really well. I'm quite excited to get it out there and then see how much further we can get away with a good antenna. And then of course the message under that is, if you need antenna design work, come to Black Art Technologies or RF Shop and we'll have a chat with you about any antenna designs you can do. We do this for Wi-Fi because we know how to do, how we could prove it, but we do it in all sorts of technologies, applications in all sorts of different frequency bands. Thanks. See you again. Bye-bye.